Hello, I'm Dr. Baines. I'm going to talk about LDN today, low-dose naltrexone, as a general overview of what to expect. And now that I've been doing it for quite a while, I also have seen quite a lot of the side effects or the benefits of it. I think it's quite useful just to understand a little bit more what it does. Now, the kind of patients coming into us for LDN are generally autoimmune patients. That's the largest number. We have a few patients with cancers, HIV, any long-term diseases, arthritis. But mostly, as I said, autoimmune based. I would also give it to someone with SIBO or any bowel, leaky gut, anything to do with the bowel at all. But saying that, we do get a large range of patients with some problems, with even including vitiligo and the rest of it. The kind of person who's the most suitable for something like LDN is basically someone who has one of those phenomena where you don't quite know what is wrong. It could be a multi-system disease, it could be an immune system that's out of whack, being too strong, or not strong at all, or not strong enough. And instead of us trying our best to spend tons of money finding out what the causes of it is, LDN raises your immune system and it uses your body's own innate intelligence to actually go and target the problem and solve the issue. Now, LDN is basically a drug that has been used for a really, really long time in the higher dose, which is 50 milligrams for addictions, very commonly used for addictions. And what it does is that it goes, attaches to the receptors in your brain, which the fact that it's connected to the receptors sort of causes a negative feedback, and your body then produces its own feel-good neurotransmitters like your endorphins. However, the quantity that's released is so little that you don't feel it because you're addicted to things that are much more powerful. At very, very low doses, you're talking about less than 5 milligrams, the same process happens, but this time, because you are not used to having all these feel-good neurotransmitters, what happens is that even the slight surplus that the negative feedback causes would actually make have a lot of benefits, in particular your immune benefits. The kind of problems that you can get with LDN, and we do get people calling in because they're in a panic when they first started, is the commonest being gut issues. You can get headaches from it, decrease in energy and well-being, swollen lymph nodes, you get sleep disturbances, rash particularly common, or burning sensation in the stomach, amongst a whole host of other things. Now, this could very well scare a lot of people off, but the way I see it is that it's doing something. At such a low dose, it's doing something in your body. You have now reignited your own immune system to go and fight things, and of course you would expect some reaction to it. Don't be scared. Persevere. I've written a few blogs on patient story. Actually, I haven't written those blogs. The patients have written those blogs because they felt that it was important enough to share with others. Please take the trouble to read them, because we need to understand from perspectives of people where it's been good and it's been not great. But for those who persevere, generally for me, if you were to get a side effect, it's actually a good thing. And I find that these people function really, really well if they're able to stick it out. And with LDN, in my experience, it works for a lot of people, but it doesn't work for everybody. You will have, in terms of reaction, you could have the person where, the kind of person who would write a book about it because it's worked so beautifully for them that everything's improved in a space of a month. And you'll have the other end of the spectrum where the person finds that it has made absolutely no difference, or they feel quite a bit worse from it. And then majority fall into the middle spectrum where there is some benefits for it, and then they wonder how long they should be on it because they don't feel like it's possibly doing enough. LDN comes in many different forms, and my personal favorite form is the sublingual form, which is this. Now, as little as it looks, this can actually last initially probably around 2 months, and after that probably about a month. We start off with one single drop, and the drops basically look something like this. Every drop is very similar, and they all each drop is equivalent to 0.5 milligrams. So generally we start with one drop initially for about 5 to 7 days. If you don't have a reaction, we then up it to 1 milligram and so on and so forth till we reach about 4.5 or 5 milligrams. So this bottle initially, as little as it looks, can last you for around a good 2 months initially, and after that, around about a month. A few frequently asked questions that we have on LDN is how soon will I see the effects? Once again, it depends on your side effects. If you were getting side effects, chances are you'll see the effects sooner rather than later, if you're happy to persevere with the side effects. In terms of the other question we get asked a lot is how long should I be on it? If you have an acute problem like a leaky gut, which can heal completely in most instances, you probably need to be on it until it's completely healed and then you're fine to go off. But if you have an autoimmune condition, by the very nature of autoimmunity, it's a lifelong thing, it needs to be managed throughout. I would definitely recommend that you be on it for as long as you possibly can. Having seen lots and lots of LDN patients by this point, I feel very hopeful. I'm loving it, frankly. And I feel very hopeful for the patients who come to me. But the one thing I've learned more than anything else with having prescribed LDN for so long is perseverance is frankly the key.